Jesus proved that he was all-powerful. He conquered lack, he conquered sickness, he conquered sin, and he conquered death. And he gave us that same authority. In Matthew 28, he says, everything that I've done, now I'm asking you to go do. Go preach the gospel, go cast out demons, go lay hands on the sick, and they will be healed. I'm giving you the same power and authority that I walked in. See, God didn't call us to live intimidated, weak, sad, tired, exhausted lives. God called us to live powerful lives. You don't have to wake up feeling bad about yourself or feeling intimidated by circumstances around you. You can wake up feeling refreshed. You can wake up and decide, today I'm going to have power. I'm going to have strength. I'm going to finish strong in life, no matter what you're going through. You know, maybe you're a mom and you're thinking, man, I've just been exhausted trying to take care of all my kids. Maybe you're a dad or a husband and you're trying to please everybody and you're feeling just overwhelmed. God wants you to walk in authority. He wants you to walk in victory, not in defeat. God wants you to be refreshed and renewed with the calling that He has for you, not exhausted and tired and weary. But see, I'm telling you, college students, teenagers, young adults, God wants us to walk in boldness. We have to receive it the right way. We can't go about trying to get it or manipulate people or force ourselves on people. God wants us to receive power from on high. So how do we do that? Well, look how Jesus received His power. He didn't receive it by going around forcing His way on others, going around trying to do a hidden agenda. He said, I'm here about my Father's business. What was Jesus saying? He was saying, I am undercover. I am under the authority of someone who's greater than me. We cannot operate in full power if we're trying to do things on our own. We have to come under authority. We have to get under the covering of what God has for us. Where is that authority? It's in the Scriptures. That authority is God's Word. It's praying that prayer every day. Lord, not my will, but Thy will be done. See, Jesus didn't have to go to the cross. If His flesh was making the decision, I'm sure His flesh would have said, no way that I'm getting up on a cross for people that I don't even know for generations to come. But Jesus said, it's not about me. It's about the will of the Father. Remember when Paul was going through those strenuous days and he was shipwrecked and he was getting beaten and whipped and he said, Lord, I'm exhausted, I'm weak. And God said, my grace is sufficient for you. 2 Corinthians 11, he says, when you are weak, I am strong. So we find strength in admitting our weakness, in admitting our dependence upon God, in coming undercover, under authority from God. God wants to empower you. He wants to give you strength. And right now, I just want to challenge you to think about those areas in your life where maybe you've been trying to do things your own way. Right now, it's time to bring it undercover, under authority, receive power from on high.